Hello, MBT supporters. I'd like to talk to you today about the experiments and getting them done, and also about some work we have upcoming, things that we would like to do that we'll need your support to do them. It's something that requires a lot of labor, and we're just a volunteer organization, and there aren't that many of us, so we want to enlist as many as we can to help us accomplish these goals. So first off, let me just talk about the experiments. Okay, we have, at the present time, found a group of physicists at a major university who are willing to do the experiments. We do not have a contract signed with them yet, but it looks like it's going to work. So everything looks positive at this time. If it does work as planned, we should have the first three of the five experiments done by mid-year, say mid-summer of 2019, this year. So that's only, a few months away from now. So that's the best news. Now, they're not going to do all of the experiments. We're going to use a simple double slit configuration setup, and that will allow us to do the first three of the experiments. Those three experiments have some major theoretical concerns tied up with them, so that will be very, very good. Now, the two that they're not going to be able to do will be the two that have very complex setups. They're more difficult and more expensive to set up, and they need a different source of particles, so they're just completely different from the first three. So we have not contracted to do those yet, but we're still looking for the right people to do those. Now, those two that I'm talking about are the ones that let the experimenter predict how particles will reflect at a beam splitter and how atoms will decay. In other words, what direction will that decay particle move in? Those are the two dramatic, but those will have to wait a little later. The first three actually resolve some fundamental quantum mechanics issues. So with those done, it should be easier to get the others done. So that's coming up. That's the good news. We'll let you know more details as we get contracts signed and things become finalized. All right, the other thing I want to talk to you about is that we would like to make the MBT material more accessible. Okay, now what the problem is that the MBT books are large and intimidating for many readers, and the video and audio on YouTube is massive. I think it's over 500 videos there, and most of it residing within long segments lasting two or more hours each. Many people who could gain much benefit from MBT concepts will never access the available material. Well, the solution is to make the MBT model and its accumulated content more accessible to both its current and to future audiences. So how are we going to go about doing this? We'd like to reorganize the existing MBT content into smaller, more focused chunks of information that speak to specific interests and issues. That is, create user-friendly online platforms and processes to provide informational and educational resources for people who are interested in learning more about MBT concepts and for those who need help, guidance, and encouragement in applying these concepts. So the bottom line is we're looking for a team of enthusiastic volunteers to help us create new ways to make MBT content more useful and accessible to the general public, and to help us implement these ideas by providing the many hands and minds that will be necessary to make it happen. So first, let me tell you a little bit about what our vision is. How do we think we should approach this? Well, initially, we'd like to organize all the MBT content on YouTube by subject, category, and timestamp. With some new material added and a bit of polishing, these chunks of subject-specific content could then be organized further into audiobooks, apps for handheld devices and computers, frequently asked question pages with links, and both formal and informal course material focused toward various types of users and interests. For example, focused on the beginners, the people who don't know much about MPT but would like to see if they're interested or not. Just get the toe into the water. The big toe, that is. It could be for advanced people who have been working with MPT for years, children of various ages, people who are interested in metaphysics, people who are interested in science or self-help or philosophy or theology or letting go of fear, interested in relationships, exploring the larger consciousness system, healing, remote viewing, death, the MBT model, etc. There's lots of ways we can break this out in subject category. Eventually, these courses would incorporate other educational media forms using illustrations, slides, animations. Ultimately, we would like to produce an interesting, entertaining, and informative MBT consciousness and science documentary film that would have the potential to reach a very large number of viewers. Now that's the vision. We don't expect to do all these things, you know, this year or next or maybe even next several. These are going to take a lot of time, but this is just kind of the big picture of how we would like to go forward in the future. Now all of this is going to take an awful lot of work to create and implement and cannot be accomplished without many volunteers over many years. Hopefully, one day, this effort to make MBT more accessible will become self-sustaining. That is, we'll be able to afford paid staff. Well, what about in the near term? What would we like to do first? Well, more specifically, our initial goals are, one, make all of my posted material, mostly YouTube video and audio, searchable by subject. These more easily digestible topic-specific chunks of content could, among other things, be made available by a free downloadable app for handheld devices. An app that would allow you to bring in the subject material that you're most interested in and put it in an MP3 player for your drive to work or put it on your computer to look at that particular video. Secondly, we'd like to develop some courses that include exercises to integrate MBT concepts into daily life. And the first course we'd like to develop would be one having to do with the practice of letting go of fear. Make that into a series of audio and maybe video or an interactive course with me. We don't know the details yet, but we would like to make a course so that people could get a little help and encouragement in getting rid of that fear. Thirdly, we'd like to make both of the above two goals more accessible through translation into different languages. So if you know English real well, know MBT concepts real well, and also know another language that you could help do translations into that other language and have the time to volunteer, we could really use that sort of help. And lastly, we'd like to develop and maintain a better informed and connected MBT community. Develop a social space designed to support and encourage individual growth. Okay, if you have the time and the inclination to volunteer, we would love to hear from you. We're trying to assess how many volunteers with what sort of skills will be available. Well, if this sounds like it's something that you would find interesting and rewarding, please reply directly to Vanessa. Vanessa is a member of the MBT support group, and her email is info@lowentropy.ca. CA means she's in Canada. That is Vanessa's business email. She runs a group called Low Entropy and has been supporting MBT discussion groups and other MBT things for the last several years. Please, if you get in touch with Vanessa, please include your name, give us contact information, how you would best like us to contact you, provide a list of the skills that you have that you think might be useful, and tell us where in this wide world you live. You don't have to give us a lot of details, just the city you live in and the country that city is in. Okay, we hope you will take this opportunity to join our all-volunteer team, exploring the possibilities, assessing the most promising approaches, and implementing the best ideas. So, for those of you who think that this would be something you could do, it's going to require time. We're going to need an awful lot of people to break up those more than 500 videos I have out on YouTube into chunks of content that express a single subject or related subjects. That is going to take a lot of volunteers. Each one may be just having to do a few hours of that breaking it up, maybe a couple of hours, but we have probably thousands of hours of that content out there, and that will require a large number of volunteers to make this kind of information accessible to the general public. Well, that's all I wanted to say. I just wanted to tell you that hopefully, if things go as we plan, we'll have some results of our experiments this summer, sometime maybe mid to late summer, and that we have this ambition to make MBT more accessible to more people. And in order to do that, we'd like to make the MBT content that's out there much easier and much more focused to individual needs, much easier to get to, easier to find what you want, and focused by subject. All right, so if you think you have the skills, the knowledge, and the time, this will take some time, to help us with this, please get in touch with Vanessa at info@lowentropy.ca, and she will begin to group all of the volunteers and see just how much of this we can take on and how long it's going to take us to do it. So thank you so much. I appreciate all the support I've gotten over the years, all the interest I've gotten. You folks out there that are supporters of MBT are wonderful, and I appreciate the interest that you have had over the years. That's what has made all the difference. So thank you.